Hello, I'm Leah Scott Price, and I am a comic book author, and this is a Q&A about my writing, my comic book series, and my characters. Is this a religious comic book about guardian angels? Vampire Guardian Angels is not a religious comic book. It is a vampire series. It is a horror action comic book. These are not loving, helpful angels that save you. A vampire is undead. So are your vampire guardian angels undead? Well, they're just as undead as any vampire. And because vampires are undead and immortal and are made by other vampires, they are undead. They're immortal. Guardian angels were made when a male human dies and their soul ascends to heaven. And they resurrect as guardian angels, and they get bitten when a vampire invades heaven. And then the whole process, it's like a chain reaction where they get bitten. Guardian angels get bitten and turn into vampires. The difference is that when a vampire guardian angel dies, they can be resurrected as long as they can get back to heaven. And in the comic book series, you'll see, you can read how. What do vampire guardian angels smell like? Yes, I've actually been asked this question. They smell like incense. So that could also be a clue to know that they're coming or they're nearby. How does one kill a vampire guardian angel? Only a good vampire guardian angel can kill a bad one. Or a vampire guardian angel who has turned back to good can kill a bad one. You can also stab a vampire guardian angel or a bad one if you have the blood of a good angel smeared on any weapon or object. How do vampire guardian angels kill? Vampire guardian angels use all types of swords to slice and slash their victims. They can even shoot their victims. They prefer to slice open their victims with sharp weapons because they're lazy. It's biting them is too cliche and it's too much struggling and work. So it's just like slice, slice, eat, eat, mealtime. What is the appetite of a vampire guardian angel like? They're zombie-like. It's a zombie-like appetite. They can drink blood, they can consume human flesh and body parts and anything. I mean, they can consume the entire human if they wanted to, except for the bones. They're not limited to blood. They can live off bodily fluids. How can evil vampires turn a guardian angel evil? Technically, something evil, such as a vampire, cannot affect something good. Such as a guardian angel, right? Because holiness supposedly cancels out and destroys evil. But there's a loophole. If a supposedly good guardian angel is already resentful and disillusioned about their job of having to stay good towards humans, and if they rebel and start doing bad things to humans on purpose, then yes, they can be affected by evil. They see a way out of their jobs by becoming vampires. And yes, evil vampires can take over something holy, such as guardian angels. Can vampire guardian angels see their reflections in the mirror? Short answer, yes. Are the stories good versus evil? Not entirely. The story starts off with a good angel pursuing a bad one, but over time, guardian angels turn bad. The heroes become resentful and tired of being protectors, and it becomes a fight between angels to see who rules over mankind. And just like humans, good ones can turn bad, bad ones can turn good, but you never know. There's always like twists and turns. How are guardian angels almost invincible? Since ancient times, all angels in heaven were trained to be soldiers and have superior fighting skills. They are kind of a supernatural super soldier. They carry swords, they know how to use all sorts of weapons, and they are immune to, again, holy water, crucifixes, sunlight. Holy water may just sting them a little. Crucifixes don't affect them because they are angels and already holy in origin, and they are ancient immortals who can heal and regenerate through a secret potion that's in the stories. So yes, they are basically almost invincible. I mean, it would really, really take a lot to try to kill them. I mean, you can shoot them up and stab them, and then it just doesn't have any effect. Can vampire guardian angels drink alcohol? Oh yeah, yeah. They get quite drunk too. Do vampire guardian angels have cell phones? Yeah, yeah. And SUVs and computers and modern equipment. In addition to their medieval weaponry, they still prefer to make their headquarters in churches, basilicas, and monasteries, but they have headquarters all over the world and a whole stockpile of weapons of all kinds. And yes, vampire guardian angels also have armies that they equip with all sorts of weapons. Please like and subscribe to my videos and watch my vampire guardian angels films and animation. And please check out my work at patreon.com/LeahScottPrice, where I have my comic book series, my novels, and my drawing lessons and tips, and my writing tips, and Q&A and facts about my vampire guardian angels characters. Thanks for watching.